Episode 97. Bandits.
Hurry up and eat. The food is getting cold.
Peter didn't realize that he had overcooked the pork. It was tough and chewy and hard to swallow. Ginny tried to smile.
It tastes good, but it's a bit... How should I say this?
Peter couldn't help but laugh.
Let me try it. I'll eat with you.
Then, he sat beside her and tasted the food.
It's good, isn't it?
Ginny tried a mouthful and repeatedly nodded her head to express her appreciation.
You like it?
Peter looked surprised.
Then I'll cook for you every day.
Ginny quickly replied,
Every day? You really don't have to. Was he joking? She could not eat that every day.
Peter turned his face to look at her. What did she mean by that? She had spoken in a ridiculing tone. Ginny tried desperately to fix the situation.
I know you're busy and don't have time to cook for me every day, but I love it.
The next second, she started to eat as fast as she possibly could. She only looked at Peter again after finishing the last piece, feeling stuffed.
I need to talk to you about something. Since we're done eating, can you help my best friend now?
She was still thinking about her. She saw his dark expression and thought he was going to go back on his word again. Maybe she had misunderstood. She couldn't help but twitch her mouth.
Peter, are you going to help her?
He gave her a cold look.
You know that I don't want to do it.
Ginny almost started yelling.
Peter, you have to do this for me! You have to!
He sighed helplessly.
Ugh, all right. Let's go get some sleep, and we can talk about this in the morning.
Ginny agreed.
All right, I'm going to bed. Don't forget about my best friend.
I'll let Lewis deal with this.
Peter nodded. He looked at her and sensed that something was different. She finally felt relieved. She trusted Lewis. He would take care of everything. The next evening, Ginny woke up to a ringing phone. She had fallen asleep on the sofa. It was already 7 p.m. She looked at the phone and immediately became more clear-headed.
Jane, what's wrong?
Ginny, thank you. Chairman Dawson's assistant called Tina and then told me that I won't lose my job. Thank you so much, Ginny.
Jane was truly happy. She would definitely seize this opportunity. When Ginny heard this, she was also happy for her friend. No matter what, as long as Jane was okay, everything would be fine. It seemed that Peter was a man who kept his word.
We should celebrate!
The two of them chatted for a little while longer before they hung up. Ginny stretched her back. She had slept for quite a long time. It was already completely dark outside, and there was no one in the huge house. Peter was not there either. He was working late. Ginny suddenly felt a little scared. She got up and turned on the light in her room, but it was still not bright enough. She walked out and prepared to turn on the lights in the living room. Next to her room was Peter's study, and she could hear something. Someone was there! A thief? Ginny's body trembled uncontrollably. She started shaking. Did the thief think there was no one home? She didn't know what to do. If she were to rush out now, would she... Ginny didn't dare to continue thinking about that. She tried her best to calm herself down. She crept back to her room, quickly closing all the windows and locking the door. She felt her heart beating faster, and she almost couldn't breathe. She quickly dialed Peter's number, but the call didn't go through. She was extremely scared, but didn't dare to make a sound.
Clang!
The thief seemed to have realized that there was someone else in the house and was banging on the door. Ginny stared at the door in fear. Oh, Peter, why wasn't he picking up his phone? The clanging lasted for more than 10 minutes, and then it was suddenly all quiet. However, Ginny was unable to relax. She continued to call Peter over and over.
Hello?
Finally, the call connected, and Peter's low voice came through.
Peter, I think there's a thief in the house. Come back, all right? I'm scared.
Ginny whispered quietly.
Bang!
The sound of metal hitting metal was especially loud this time. The thief was quiet for a while. He didn't leave or give up, but found some tools and smashed the door even harder. It seemed like he wouldn't stop until he opened the door. Ginny was so scared that she shrunk into a corner of the room.
Peter, I...
Wait for me.
He looked at everyone in the conference room.
The meeting will continue tomorrow.
After saying that, he had already reached the door of the room. He quickly disappeared from everyone's sight, leaving the shareholders and executives in the room, looking at each other in dismay. They didn't know what was going on. Only Declan Lockhart frowned. He felt that something was not right. He looked at Lewis, who also didn't know what was going on, then pulled him aside and asked,
"Is it Ginny?"
Lewis nodded. During the meeting, Peter's cell phone kept ringing, but he didn't answer. Peter hadn't looked at his phone, but Lewis had noticed that the caller was Ginny.